Hey, today is Darwin Day, marking what would be pioneering naturalist Charles Darwin's 199th birthday. Celebrations, lectures, and even a few barbecues are being held in his honor. And our guest today is Richard Milner. He usually has many other things to be doing on this day, performances, parties. He's got the day off for the first time in years. He's usually performing his one-man musical show called Charles Darwin Live and in Concert. Thanks for being here. We want to get right into the music and the musical, this tribute that you have crafted to Charles Darwin. Tell us a little bit about what we're going to hear. There's something in the song that has to do with Thomas Huxley, correct?
Thomas Huxley was Darwin's great friend, known as Darwin's bulldog, because Darwin was very reticent about arguing in public, and Huxley loved to debate the bishops, and he would go out and fight for the theories, and he had a famous debate with the Bishop of Oxford in 1860, where the bishop said, perhaps Professor Huxley can tell us, is he descended from an ape on the side of his grandfather or his grandmother? And Huxley rose and he said, ladies and gentlemen, my lord bishop, it would have never occurred to me to ask such a question. When we speak of descent in biology, we speak in terms of thousands, millions of years, not in terms of one's own familial ancestry. But if the question is put to me, would I rather have for an ancestor a venerable grinning ape or a man? A man of great oratory, of power, of intellect, of prestige, position, and talent, who uses that talent and that position and that privilege for the mere purpose of making a mockery of those engaged in serious scientific inquiry, why then I unhesitatingly affirm my preference for the ape. Well, the audience was aghast. A woman fainted, and Huxley became a celebrity overnight. But when Huxley had first read The Origin of Species in 1859, his initial reaction was, of course, how stupid of me not to have thought of that myself. And so Richard Milner thought, there's a song cue if ever I heard one. And so if you'll hit the music, we have Huxley singing, Why Didn't I Think of That? Of course, it must be so. I should have seen it long ago. 'Twas adaptive radiation that produced the mighty whale. His hands have grown to flippers, and he has a fishy tail. Selections made him streamline for his liquid habitat. Why didn't I think of that? There was an ancient mammal that could hop and leap around, but with Weller twixt his fingers, he could fly right off the ground. And so this mousy creature evolved into a bat. Why didn't I think of that? There are fossils in the ground, protozoa in the sea, all these unrelated facts made a monkey out of me. But now I see how species were selectively defined. How could I have been so ruddy blind? There was an ancient monkey with a long and curly tail. This ape evolved into a man. He's teaching now at Yale. A chimp could pass for upper class in gloves and a cravat. Why didn't I think of that? The struggle for survival lies outside the jungle, too. Just take a look at Parliament. It's better than a zoo. We're at each other's throats, just like the bulldog and the cat. But why didn't I? Your ideas on evolution will create a revolution. Why didn't I think of that?